What is quasi cryptocurrency? Who is Mithali Raj? What are the important joint military exercises that India indulges in? These are the questions that we're going to answer in today's current affairs that we're going to cover in Morning Tales. Hello everyone, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to the Morning Tales, and today we are going to cover current affairs for April 19th, 2019. It's 8 a.m. in the morning and I'm going to take some quizzes with you guys, and I want you guys also to be equally engaged and take complete participation in this quiz that we're going to hold today. Before moving forward, let's have a look at certain corrections that I wanted to make, because you would not believe it, but a lot of newspapers make a lot of mistakes nowadays because of the fight to produce everything, to publish everything as fast as possible. So on 17th April, there was one question which was concerned, or which was talking about the rate of growth of exports in India, as you can see here. And as per that report that I read, as per that article that I read in the newspaper, the rate of growth for this year was given as 8%, but it actually is 7.9%. That's the first correction that you want to make in your notes as well. And the second one, which is a major blunder that these newspapers have made, and I found it out the next day when I went through the entire report of Ministry of Commerce, is that the trade deficit, overall trade deficit, is not 176.42 billion. The overall trade deficit is only 95.85 billion. The trade deficit that these newspapers have referred to is the merchandise or goods trade deficit that you can see here. And that was an important that is an important correction that you would want to make. These are all the data points of exports and imports. All these data points are available on the website for current affairs of 17th April, and you can go there and check out all these data points there itself. So this was the first correction that I wanted you to make. The second one is about Durjanpur, which I discussed yesterday. The question was, what is the name of the new town which has been created out of Durjanpur? But the correction is that Durjanpur, whose name has been changed, is not in Haryana, it's in MP. So there are two Durjanpurs, one in MP and one in Haryana. The one that whose name has been changed is in MP, not in Haryana. So if you want to know where MP is and where Haryana is, MP is here at the center of India and Haryana lies just below Punjab. The third correction that we would want to make is regarding IDBI Bank. Number one, we talked about paperless banking for NRIs. Paperless banking, a lot of students were asking me, so do they not have to give any kind of papers? Well, paperless banking refers here to no need to provide hard copies if you want to open an account, if you want to go for some transactions, so on and so forth. Paperless banking means that it's completely online, it's completely digital now. So that was the idea, that was the purpose of paperless banking, which a lot of students misunderstood, so I wanted to make that correction. Next one, I said that IDBI has is a public sector bank, not a private sector bank. Well, there are two aspects to this, which I clarified in the comment section also below. So it's always important that you provide comments, whether you have doubts, whether you want to say something to me, whether there's a feedback, whatever it might be. So a student talked with me and said that IDBI is a private sector bank, and so we researched on it and we found out that for regulatory purposes by RBI, it's considered a private sector bank. But for all the other purposes, whether it's legal, whether it's related to staff, whether it's related to how they're going to recruit, whether it's related to how they're going to pay to their staff, all for all those things, it is going to be considered as a public sector bank, not as a private sector bank. Okay, so these are the corrections that I wanted to make. Now let's move to current affairs for today. The first question is, when is World Heritage Day observed? A very important question. Such important dates have often been asked in the examination, so I want you guys to cover them very comprehensively. 2 to 3 marks right there, increase or decrease, and 2 to 3 marks are not less when we're talking about these competitive exams. Okay, the question is, when is World Heritage Day observed? The answer to this question is E, April 18th. Now, what exactly is World Heritage Day? The International Day for Monuments and Sites, that's the entire name of World Heritage Day. That's important. International Day for Monuments and Sites. What is the purpose And it was proposed by which organization? It was actually proposed by International Council on Monuments and Sites, which stands for ICOMOS, ICOMOS, in 1982. And it was approved by UNESCO in 1983. What is the purpose? Very obvious, the purpose is to preserve these kind of monuments and sites, the ancient architecture around the world, to increase awareness at the same time about these heritage sites, and also to improve and preserve the diversity of cultural heritage in the entire world. So those are the keywords that you would want to remember. Whether it's UPSC, those things are important. Whether it's RBI, you would want to understand what World Heritage Day stands for in order to be able to recall it better in the future. Okay. The next question is, what is the name of the quasi cryptocurrency launched by IMF and World Bank? The word quasi here holds a lot of importance because it's not actually a cryptocurrency which has been launched by IMF and World Bank. It's a quasi cryptocurrency only for learning. The answer, if you know it, put it in the comment section below. I would want to see how many of you can actually answer it before I answer it. The answer to this question, well, is C, learning coin. And as the name only says, or it means, the purpose of this quasi cryptocurrency is to improve learning, is to encourage students of all ages to come and learn about how cryptocurrencies work in real life scenarios. Okay, what's a cryptocurrency? Well, that's for a different discussion, but in short, it's a tradable digital asset. It's a digital form of money which is tradable, and it is normally built on blockchain technology that only exists online. The purpose is to increase digital transactions through digital form of money which is created completely online, which does not have any kind of offline presence. Okay. The third question for today is, who among the following has been appointed as the goodwill ambassador of the Indian team in the Street Children's Cricket World Cup? Now, why this question is important, you might be thinking. It's not important at all. We have so many ambassadors being appointed on a daily basis. Well, this is important because this particular tournament, Street Children's Cricket World Cup 2019, is the first time that a cricket tournament around the world, which is of a World Cup level, has been created, has been hosted for street children. The purpose is to increase awareness about the importance of what street children indulge in the way of playing any kind of sport, whether it's cricket, whether it's football, any kind of sport, it doesn't matter. And who is the goodwill ambassador? The answer is A, Mithali Raj. Who is Mithali Raj? Mithali Raj is the captain of India's cricket team, women's cricket team, and she's been named as the goodwill ambassador. And some other people in the field of cricket have also come forward to join this particular movement. Saurav Ganguly and Rajasthan Royals, they're supporting this entire movement of encouraging street cricket. Okay, let's come to the fourth question. Who has been appointed as the executive director of Punjab National Bank? Well, you don't need to remember all the directors, executive directors, and all the appointments made in all the banks, but certainly because this person has been appointed recently, in fact today, so it becomes important if the exam is held in the near future. The answer is A, Rajesh Kumar Yadubanshi. Now, an interesting and a confusing phenomena here, there are two Sunil Mehtas in Punjab National Bank. The managing director and CEO is Sunil Mehta, who's a different person, and the non-executive chairman is also Sunil Mehta, who's a different person. So don't get confused here, because both of them are Sunil Mehtas, but both of them are different people, as you can see here very clearly. Non-executive chairman Sunil Mehta, MD and CEO Sunil Mehta, becomes easier for us, but you just need to remember that there are different people. Okay, last question for today. INVPN, Bilat X Maritime Bilateral Exercise is conducted between which countries? It's an easy question. You can figure it out from the name itself. IN is India, VPN should be Vietnam, and this is the flag of Vietnam. Well, before concluding it, I would like to bring to you and provide you all the important bilateral exercises that India participates in. With Russia, what's the name? Indra. With Singapore, the important one, Simbex. Okay, We have with let's say Sri Lanka, Mitra Shakti, important one. With Mongolia, very important, nomadic elephant. That's very important. With Nepal, an important one, Surya Kiran. If you want to provide it in the comment section below, go forward and provide it. Let me ask you a question. What is the name of bilateral exercise which India holds with Japan? There are two of them, but only one of them is important. I want you to provide it. Answer it in the comment section below. With Seychelles, L'Amitié, important one again. Okay. With China, hand in hand, very important. With Australia, AusIndex, very, very important. With Thailand, another one which has often been asked, Maitri. With Thailand, Maitri. With UAE, because that's a desert, so Desert Eagle. Okay. With Maldives, another important one, Equiwerin. With Maldives, the name is Equiwerin. You need to remember these names. Any of them can be asked in the examination. Okay. There are certain trilateral and quadrilateral exercises also, but we're not discussing them today. So these were all the important bilateral exercises. Of course, there are a lot more bilateral exercises that India indulges in. If you know any of them and remember any of them right now, provide it in the comment section below so that you can share it with everybody, because you know sharing is caring. So that was all for today's current affairs. I hope you liked it. If you did, subscribe to the channel immediately and press the bell icon so that you don't miss out on the future videos. All the very best. Take care.